studio to talk about the earnings this time. Mr. Natarajan, good morning and thank you for joining us. It's been a steady quarter for you, the revenue growth of almost 7.5%. But just take us through what the dollar revenue performance has been and what the constant currency growth has looked like.
Dollar revenue growth sequential is 5.6%. So it is actually one of our best quarters, because sequential growth of 5.6% is really good for us. And overall, I think the driver is clearly digital, because our investments in digital, e-commerce, mobile commerce, I think that's really paying off. And given the trends in the U.S. market, I'm pretty bullish that that'll take us forward.
This is the dollar revenue. It's not the constant currency growth.
It's, I mean, constant currency is a little higher, actually.
Okay. What about deal wins then? Can you also tell us from where the deals came?
See, our deals are coming from all over. Currently, we have a pipeline of close to, what, 390 million. And that's roughly 140 million in the IM space, infrastructure management. The rest is a combination of digital and traditional enterprise business. So it's coming primarily from the US. That's our focus. In fact, we have a large deal pipeline of close to 160 million, which is all deals over 20, 30 million. And I think that's coming at a very steady clip. In fact, we just signed up one of the largest retailers in the world to look at their entire new e-commerce platform. So once you are, you know, in a position to provide an end-to-end e-commerce service, I think that really changes the complexion of the game.
Are the margins better in that?
Sorry?
Are the margins better in e-commerce and digital?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, if you look at the e-commerce rollouts that we do, I mean, you're talking about bill rates of, it could go as high as $160 to $200 per hour on-site and as high as $50 per hour offshore. So, I mean, that's the lead. And then it leads into maintenance business, other collateral businesses. So I think that's, as a strategy, it's really working for us.
You said you just signed a deal with one of the largest retailers. How big could that deal be?
Now, the deal is to build out their entire ATG platform. So that'll be roughly 12 million at the first pop. But then that kind of leads to a lot of follow-on business in terms of, you know, you really build out the rest of their mobile commerce and e-commerce strategy. So that just leads to multiple stuff.
Okay. So you mentioned that you mentioned that digital is the main driver for you now. Currently, it forms about 15% of your revenues.
Yeah, this quarter is just upwards of 15%.
So going forward in the next couple of years, how much could it contribute?
Well, in theory, it's 50%, but I mean, let's see how it plays out. But
okay,
clearly, we've come from what was probably 2% 2 years back to now 15%. And as I said, I think they're in all the right spots. Social listening, e-commerce, mobile commerce, cloud, of course, everybody is in. But I think the ability to crack the whole e-commerce model, that's what's going for us today.
Okay. What might be the guidance in terms of revenue growth for the full year or for subsequent quarters? Can we expect this as a pro rata run rate?
No, I wouldn't like to say that. As you know, seasonally, the third quarter is always bad. And you never know which client wakes up in a bad mood and says 2 weeks furlough. So third quarter is unpredictable. But I think given the pipeline, given the order book, it looks pretty good, and this year will be a good year for Zensar.
So it would be what, 20%? Some idea of what might the year look like?
No idea. You just pro rata and then subtract whatever you feel like.
Okay, what about margins? There you're more sure. I mean, you're crawling higher, so does it get to 16 or even better?
Yeah, right now we're just under, I think, what, 15% EBITDA. And that's good. And our PAT as a percentage, 12.2%, is the highest ever. So I think the goal, which I've said in the past also, is to cross the 10%, which we did, and maintain that. And I think if we continue to do more IM services deals, because products tend to be very low, and we're completely downplaying the infrastructure management products business. So if we focus on new services, focus on digital, I mean, there's no other place for the margins to go but up. Plus, of course, like everybody else, automation, productivity improvement, flattening of the pyramid, all that is on.
In fact, in infrastructure management, your margins have fallen this time. Why, sir?
Infrastructure management, I mean, we have had a slow quarter because the product business has been down. It'll again, see, it's very seasonal. Products business will be fantastic in the current quarter because that is when end of the year for American companies, they do all their buying. So it's still a kind of a wobbly business. But the good news is last four quarters have been profitable. And going forward, we see, you know, very good uptick because the order booking has been good. Both the maintenance services and the what we call remote infrastructure services will continue to grow this quarter, which is that's what trends up the margins as well.
Has the coming in of Apex partners meant any change to the...
Well, all it means is we have a new director on the board at this point, because our board meeting was only yesterday. But I'm excited. I mean, I know Apex, I know the value they can bring, both in terms of, you know, robustness of M&A, as well as potentially deal pipelines from their portfolio companies. So I think it's certainly the first strategic investor we've had, and we're looking forward to see how that plays out.
It was the former that interested me, actually, M&A. Should we expect anything?
Well, we always look. I mean, just to give you a sense of our digital e-commerce play, See, today we are very good in almost, I would say, 80% of the areas. One area where everybody looks at, and I don't think any company except probably Accenture and maybe Deloitte have played that well, is digital studios. You know, you actually have an experience center for digital, manage the user experience, and that's an area where most of us are weak. So that's one area of M&A. Big data continues to be an interesting area. So we do a lot of analytics and BI, etc. But I think if we find the right companies at the right price, which is difficult in these spaces, then you're certainly in the market.
But some of your larger peers like Infosys have given a softer guidance for the second half of the year. Do you see any problems?
I don't see any problems, but as I said, seasonally this quarter is slow, so I don't expect miracles in this quarter. But given the pipeline, I think we'll be back to good growth again in the fourth quarter. And next year is looking very good at this point.
All right, Mr. Natarajan, it's always a pleasure having you in our studio.
Thank you
very much for joining us, and congratulations on the good numbers.
Thanks.
All right, so that's the earnings season for you. Zensar coming in with much better numbers than expected. Let's get